Good morning, everyone. So today we are going to read about your first chapter, that is computer languages. Okay? So I hope everyone knows what is a computer. As computer is an electronic machine, it is a smart machine. So today we are going to discuss about its languages. Actually, which language does computer understand? Let's read about. Okay. So here we are going to read about these concepts in this chapter: program and programming concepts, machine language, assembly language, high level language, and fourth generation language. So we are going to read about these concepts in this chapter. So let's start with first, that is programming concepts. A program. So what is a program? So program is a set of instructions that tells computer what to do. So a program basically is that we need to tell computer, as computer cannot do work its own. So we have to instruct the computer so that it could follow that instruction. For example, I instruct you to sit straight in my class. So then that is the instruction you follow. So same exactly computer does. We need to give some set of instructions so that computer know what to do. So that is a program, set of instructions. Let's come to programming. So programming is a process of writing some specific instruction in computer language. Programming means the instruction we have given to computer. So computer process that instruction properly in its own language. That is known as program. So here, program and programming are the basic concepts for computer language. So here, if we read the third point, basically every language has its own protocol, has its own specific rules, instructions. Like every teacher is having their own rules, own specific instruction in class. So similarly, computer have the separate rules and regulation for its programming language. Let's now go to the first programming language, that is machine language. So here we are dividing the computer languages into four languages. The first is machine language, second is assembly language, third is high level language, and fourth is fourth generation language. So these are the four types of computer languages that we are going to read about in this chapter. So let's start with the first language, that is machine language. Okay, so we call machine language as first generation language also. So machine language is the only language that computer understands properly. So none other than any language computer understands. Computer understands only and only machine language. Why? Because it is in the form of binary digits, that is 0 and 1. So if we tell computers, if we type hello, how are you, so the computer will not be able to understand it directly. Computer will automatically convert it's in machine language and then will give you the output. So basically here we understand that computer understands only machine language as it is in the form of binary numbers, that is 0 and 1. So as you can see, the next one, that is uses binary codes to depict operators and data. So hamare paas 0 or 1 ki form mein hum koi bhi data, koi bhi apne operators डिपिक्ट कर सकते हैं, कोई भी प्रॉब्लम हम सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. सो कंप्यूटर सिर्फ जीरो और वन की फॉर्म को ही समझता है. सेकंड, इट इज मशीन डिपेंडेंट, एंड थर्ड एट द लास्ट दैट इट अंडरस्टैंड ओनली एंड ओनली मशीन लैंग्वेज. आई होप दिस लैंग्वेज इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. लेट्स मूव टू द सेकंड लैंग्वेज. सो दिस बिफोर मूविंग टू द सेकंड, एज यू कैन सी दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ मशीन लैंग्वेज. That is the first generation computer. Okay. Now we are here in assembly language. This is called the second generation language. If you are asked which language is the second generation, so the answer will be assembly language. Okay. So the difference between assembly language and machine language is that In assembly language, we use mnemonic codes or symbols in place of 0 and 1. That is, we can use add, ADD, short form, sub, SUB, multiply, MUL. These are the mnemonic codes. These are called mnemonic codes or symbol, you can say, at the rate, question mark, explanation mark. These are the some symbols. So in assembly language, we are not using 0 and 1. We are using mnemonic codes and symbols. So again, there is a problem. So if we write directly A double add or sub or direct any symbol, computer will not be able to understand. So we have to do something so that computer understands assembly language. So here is the solution with that. So computer has some translator so that a computer can understand assembly language also. So here is the translator call, you can see in the red font, that is assembler. So assembler is a type of translator. So basically translator is what? Translator is the function which translate one language to another. Okay, so same goes with assembler. Assembler translate the assembly language programs into machine language so that computer understand it properly. So here is the working of assembler. So assembler is the translator which convert whole assembly programs into machine language so that computer can understand its working properly. So we are going to see some points over it. Here again, as you remember, in machine language, we were learning that it uses binary codes 0 and 1. So here we are using mnemonic codes and symbols. Second, this is also a machine dependent. And third, it uses an assembler translator, which help in converting into machine language. Now this is, you can see the second generation computer picture. So here you can see an example, mnemonic. It is an abbreviation for an operator. And for example, you can see addition, we are writing ADD. So this is the mnemonic codes and symbol as I told you. I hope these two languages are clear with everyone. Let's move to the third. So here it is high level language, that is called third generation language. Okay, again, third generation language is very different from assembly and machine language. So high level language, it uses some high level programming languages such as C, Fortran, Pascal, C++, Java. These are high level programming languages that we are used to write some programs in a computer. But again, question arises that does a computer understands directly high level language? Does a computer understands directly these high programming languages? The answer is no. Again, we are facing the same problem. So here it is the solution that high level language programs also need to be converted into machine language so that a computer understands it and work according to this language. So before going to that, let's read these three points. It is simple and user-friendly language. It is, you can say, it uses English alphabets language also. Language that is machine independent. And these are some examples of the programming languages like C, C++, Java. So these are some high programming languages that are used in third generation language. So now let's back come to the same question. Does this language is able to understand by the computer, or what is the solution with that? Let's move with that. Here are some translator programs. Here is the solution to our problem. So as you can see, the assembler we have already understood. So these are some new translator programs. The first you can see is interpreter, and second you can see the compiler. So let's read what is actually interpreter. So interpreter and compiler, both are the translator programs used for high level language programs. So basically there is a minor difference between these two. Let's read with interpreter first. So interpreter is a type of a translator program which converts high level language programs into machine language, but with line by line. It doesn't convert the whole program at once, it converts the program line by line. Suppose if I am writing hi, how are you? So it will convert it into machine language. Like it firstly convert hi, next it will come to the second line hello, And then third line, how are you? So it is converting line by line. So that translator program is called interpreter. Next come to compiler. Compiler is also a translator program that converts high level language programs into machine language, but it doesn't convert the program line by line. It converts the program at once. It doesn't waste time with the line by line. It converts whole program at once. Suppose if I write hello, how are you, so it will convert into machine language at once. Hello, how are you, exa properly. So this is the minor difference between interpreter and compiler. And third one we have already read in the previous slide, assembler. As the name implies, it convert assembly language program into machine language so that computer understands. The working of these three translator program is same, that as computer understands only and only machine language. So that's why these three translator programs are being used. I hope these translator programs are now clear to everyone. Let's move to our last language, that is fourth generation language, and in a short way we can call it 4GL. Okay. So as you can see the picture, and you can identify that these type of computers you are using in your daily basis. Today you are using this. You are using desktop computers, you are using laptop computers, you are using tablet, you are using smartphone. So these all computers come under in fourth generation language. So it has all the main points, it has all the crucial things in today's computer. For example, it has the perfect operating system, it has a very high speed of execution, it makes the user work less, and it minimizes the minimum efforts of the user. It gives the speed of execution fast, and as you can see in the picture, these type of computer that are using in your daily basis, these computers are called fourth generation language, that is 4GL. I hope all these languages are clear to everyone. Let's take a quick revision with this. So first generation language was our machine language, that is the computer only understand it. It uses the binary numbers 0 and 1. Second, if we say that is the assembly language, that uses mnemonic codes or symbol instead of 0 and 1, and the translator assembler is used to convert into machine language so that computer understands. Then we'll come to the third language, that is third generation language. It converts again into machine language by the two translator, that is interpreter and compiler. Again, high level language use high level programming languages. You can take example like C, C++, Java, Pascal. These are some high level programming languages. And with that, it needs to be converted into machine language. So two translators are used, that is interpreter and compiler. These are some interesting facts that you should know about in this chapter. So first is Lady Ada Lovelace. She was the first programmer, first computer programmer. She was a great mathematician. Second, you should know software. The term software was first used by this scientist, that is John W. Turkey, in 1957. Next, you should know what is actually the meaning of syntax. Syntax are the some rules or some formation of statements in programming language. Har programming language mein kuch rules, kuch formation hote hain, jinke according aapko kaam karna padta. Like you are having some rules in your school that you have to follow it. According to that, you need to follow all the instructions. So that is a syntax, that is a rules. And third, you are able to see Fortran and COBOL. These are two high level programming languages. These are some computer languages. So Fortran kafi purani languages hai, aur COBOL is the again a computer language that was designed for business users. So I hope you are clear with this chapter. That is our chapter number 1, computer languages. Okay. Thank you so much everyone. Thank you.